Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I want to share with you all the polishes that are on my seasonal polish rack for the season of autumn, autumnal, fall, whatever you want to call it. These are the polishes that are on my rack. Now, last time I did the seasonal polish rack, I pulled the color categories that I have the most of, and I think I'm gonna do it this way again, and then I'll do a second video with all of my rack, if you're interested in seeing all of my rack. Before I forget, I wanna let you know what I'm wearing on my nails today. This is Wildflower Lacquer in Billy. This year, I did put them in color, like Roy G. Biv rainbow order, sort of. And instead of just by brand, it looks nice, but a little bit like, looks a little discombobulated to me just because brands aren't together and it's just driving me a little nuts. So I may have to reorganize them by color, but then by brand. I never realized how like strict I am about that stuff, because when they go in their drawers, in their color drawers, I don't care that they're mixed in, but seeing them displayed, it just kind of, it gives me the heebie-jeebies not seeing them in the color coordination or in the brand coordination that I'm used to. So the first color category that I'm going to talk about that I have an abundance of is orange, or like burnt orangey brown almost this color. This mainstream one is from OPI, and this is called Susie Needs a Locksmith. So Susie Needs a Locksmith from OPI is coming across a lot brighter, but this is a very typical burnt orangey kind of autumnal color. Definitely a lot of this on my rack. Orange representation is this Wildflower Lacquer, and this is called Tweet Hearts, and this is for the Birds collection. I've used this polish in nail art, specifically like filling in images, because on a cream, so like let's say I'll paint my nails with this and then put pumpkins on my nails in with this kind of color, filling in the pumpkins, and it looks amazing. This is definitely a lot more orangey than it looks in the bottle. I really love the way that this looks, so I can't wait to wear this as a full mani. And then we have this MJ Lacquer, and Are You Ready? You already have a brown. Now, this is supposed to be brown, but honestly, when I put it with the browns, it looks more orange. I don't know if the color has shifted a little in the years that I've had this. I think I received this one in PR, but oh my God, it is so freaking beautiful. Another color that I have an abundance of this month or this season is olive greens, because of course, olive is trending now. But I have always been a fan of olive greens. You guys should see my green drawers, which you eventually will. When I start up that series again, but I have a lot of olive greens. I just pulled these out just to show the type, I guess, that I have, even though now that I'm looking at it, they look kind of similar. These two right here look similar. The first one I'm gonna talk about is from Supernatural Lacquer. Now, I don't believe that Supernatural Lacquer is doing polishes anymore. I have two of them, or I have two of this brand. This is the Gilman, and I think this is one of the last HHC polishes that she did, and it is this beautiful murky hollow olive green. Really love it. This one I think I received in PR but never wore it, or I purchased it, I can't remember. But this is a blush lacquer in Positronic Brain, and it's suffering from olive syndrome, ugly bottle syndrome, but I still think it's going to paint wonderfully. I've had this happen with many of a polish, and I never had any issues with the actual formula or color. And then we have a Zombie Claw, and this one is Sage, and I love how this is like, this to me does not look like a sage, but I love the way that it looks. It's like a subtle shift red to this. Really pretty, really lovely, and Zombie Claw makes amazing polishes. And then the color that I have the most on my rack this season, which is usually the case, like fall's usually the time when I wear purples, but purples is what I have the most of on my rack right now. I think it's taking up almost 2.5 rows, maybe. Regardless, this is like, there's an abundance of purples. This one here is Lucky 13, oops, and this is called The Suspense is Terrible. This is from PPU, and I purchased it, and it still looks so beautiful. I don't know what it is, but on camera, the shimmer, the gold shimmer, like reddish gold shimmer that is in this polish never showcases properly. This is a beautiful, beautiful polish. I'm just not a big fan of their brush in this. Yeah, it's like a long stem brush, and I'm just not a big fan of it, and it's really thin. And this, I think this is my only Lucky 13 that I purchased. I think I may have gotten some in gifts or swaps, but this is the only one that I've purchased from them, and it is beautiful and I really want to wear it, but I never reach it. And I'm like, I'm telling myself, you're gonna reach it this month, or this season, you're going to use this polish. Next we have Night Owl Lacquer in the Buried Mood, another polish pickup that I have yet to wear. Oh my god, this is from November of 2019 and I haven't worn it yet. I am a failure. This looks amazing though. I love that it has those blue flakes in there. It's just a really nice contrast with the purple base and all of the gold orangey kind of flakes that are in there as well. I cannot wait to wear this. And we have a like grape purple, like a traditional purple. This one I would love to wear with like witch's hat. I already can see lots of stamping done in purples with witches kind of thing. For some reason I feel like purple is a good witch color. This is called Amethyst Skies and this is from March PPU. However, I did purchase this, or I did get this in a D-stash, I think, or it was gifted, I can't remember. And again, as you can tell, I'm still on the reflective glitter train that has not left the building. Majority of my fall rack is the oranges, the greens, and the purples. But I do have some outlining colors, like a lot of teals or bluish teal kind of polishes. We got a couple of berry colored or wine colored things as well, and I'm just using these as examples. I guess I should have told you this is Emily DeMolly's in Elevate You, and I have a couple of colors in this tone. I have a couple of berry wine colors, like this Enchanted Polish in Black Cherry Opal, so just like winey berry colors. I have a couple of dark polishes that lean one way or another and don't belong anywhere, like this Ethereal Lacquer in Relax It's Only Magic, where it's a super dark color but it's not really just black. I have a couple of those as well. And then I have a couple of yellows, like mustardy yellows, olive yellow leaning colors, like this Bee's Knees Lacquer and I Loved You the Same. This is a PR polish, and for some reason I always have a hard time saying that. So yeah, I had a lot of colors like this as well. So that's it. Those are all the color categories that I seem to be leaning towards this seasonal, or this season. I don't know why I said seasonal. Thank you. Let me know in the comments down below, what color categories are you leaning towards? And I am going to do a full nail rack video. That's the long one. This is the short one. This is the abbreviated version of my nail rack. I understand that I'm not going to get through all of these polishes. I have to say this every video because somebody always comments and say, you can never get through those polishes. I know. I already feel guilty enough. Don't tell me again. I understand. But I do like having the variety available to me. I like to see them. That's pretty much what it is right now. It's just a collection that I can look at and admire and say, my precious. So thanks everyone so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. I hope you enjoyed it. And leave me a comment, like, and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye.